Good morning, this is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Friday, February 15th, 2008. In the pre-market this morning, we've got futures down sharply across the board, so we are looking for the market to open lower. We would imagine the Dow is going to be down about 100 points at the open on Friday morning. Now, yesterday was a complete reversal of Wednesday's positive market activity, and a couple of reasons for that. First of all, Ben Bernanke was speaking, and people didn't like what he said, and we came into the day having the big Swiss bank UBS with negative numbers out. That caused this bank to sell off over 8%, and not only was it down yesterday, but it's down again in the pre-market this morning. This is, of course, one of the largest, most respected banks in the world, and it's down about 50% off of its highs of last year. Now, yesterday's market activity gave us a lot of new bearish reversal signals. These signals, of course, don't always work out, but we like to watch them to see if they indicate the top of a market. So there's an example of 3M, Research in Motion, Suncor Energy. Again, we need to see follow-through to confirm these signals, but they do often mark the top of a market. Now, I am trying to maintain a long-term bullish view within a bear market. This particular chart, like many charts, is currently oversold historically, indicating that this is a long-term market bottom. Now, within the context of it being a bear market, we're not expecting to break out to new highs at all. This particular chart shows the percentage of U.S. stocks that we cover that are currently trading above their 100-day moving average. And as you can see, we're at a very, very low point here. And what we're looking for is when the market does rally, you can see that this chart has been making a series of lower highs. And if we just connect the dots here, the trend line comes down to about the 30% mark. So when the market does start to rally, we get a sustainable multi-week rally, we'll probably come up to about the 30% mark and top out. I would imagine that at that point that you're going to see the S&P 500 come up to some area of resistance, whether it's a valley or one of these peaks, but we're certainly not going to come back and test the previous high. So that's what I'm looking for in the long term. On the short term, you know, we've had a couple of rally attempts, and it's mostly been aggressive short-term money has come into the market. What we haven't seen is the long-term conservative money come back into this market yet. Until that happens, we're not going to get a sustainable multi-week rally, and we're going to just continue to chop up and down, up and down. Of course, that's very frustrating for all of us, but that's what we have to live with right now. Now, looking at the 60-minute charts for Friday, the TSX did not give an hourly sell signal on Thursday. If it closes below 13,210, and I think that's going to do it in the first hour of trading, we will get a new intraday sell signal on the TSX. The S&P 500 is in an intraday downtrend, and so we need an hourly close above 13,62 on Friday. The NASDAQ, we need an hourly close above 23,58. And looking at the VIX started to move up at the end of the day, hasn't started a new hourly uptrend, but if we get an hourly close above 25.50 on Friday, that's down from the 26 we were looking at on Thursday. So if we get an hourly close above 25.50 on the VIX, we will be in a new intraday uptrend for the VIX, which should help support the down move in the market. Now, looking at the XAU, for gold stocks, we're in an hourly downtrend, and if we were able to move up above 179 on Friday, that would give us a new intraday buy signal. Okay, that's all for Friday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we're closed on Monday, and we'll be back to talk to you again on Tuesday morning.